Welcome back. I'm with three beautiful women. You just saw one of them. That was Heather. Heather Fontaine is her name. She's also with Amanda Winters and Shalei Lutrell. We're talking about female impersonation. We're talking to three women who self-described transsexuals. We're certainly not making any moral judgment here. We're here to examine, as I said earlier, a very, very interesting lifestyle. I'd like to take some questions from my audience. Questions? Yes, ma'am. Would you stand, please?
Heather, does your family treat you as a woman?
Yes.
Thank you. Another question? Yes, sir. Would you stand?
Heather, was your first sexual experience with a girl?
With my what?
Was your first sexual experience with a girl?
No, I've never had any relations with a woman sexually.
I think it's important here to point out that these are men, biologically born men, who have felt all their lives that they want to be women. And this is their way of demonstrating this. Yes, sir, would you come out here, please?
These men had surgical operations in the genital area.
Have any of you had
no.
Surgery?
No.
Thank you, sir. Which brings up a point. I watched the monitor, the dancing. I saw no evidence of any genitals. What do you do with that?
We leave them at home.
I mean, that may not be very, you know, gentlemanly, but I, what happens? What happens to it?
Well,
All right, first of all, in the hormone treatment, does that affect the organ itself?
Definitely.
What does it do? Does it reduce the size of it?
Well, the testicles are no longer as enlarged as they were originally.
All right.
And in performing, we just use a firmer underwear. And I don't think we'll have to go into details on how we do it.
I think I mean, there are just so many places that can go. Right? So what you do is you wear
home.
Pardon? No. So you just wear very firm underwear, which tucks it up very close to your bodies. Right. Are any of you planning on having the surgery?
Yes, I am.
Heather, you are?
Yes.
At what point?
As soon as I feel that I'm old enough and ready.
When you say ready, do you mean further studies, further therapy, or just you?
No, as far as having a career to go into and just, you know, basically ready. I need to be older, I think.
Yeah,
there's no coming back after that.
Excuse me?
There's no coming back after that.
No.
All right, yes.
When she's saying ready, I think she means that you have to, at a certain point in your life, be mentally prepared for it. Because once you consider the operation and the operation is done, there's no going back.
Right.
And if there is any way of going back, for one, you're not going to be sexually active. You know? I mean, I don't think it's possible right now from going from one extreme to the other and back. I mean, it's done, you know? And as far as cosmetically, I would say, okay, it's not much of a problem, but it's the function of the surgery that's going to be very important. And it's vital that mentally you be prepared for it. And you cannot be prepared 100%, because who knows until they actually get it done.
How it's going to turn out.
How it's going to turn out.
Are you going to have it done? Are you thinking about it?
Yes, I have thought about it.
Amanda?
Yes.
Both of you. But you're all three waiting for what you consider to be the right time emotionally.